With heavy hearts and a steely determination to move on, New York has come to a standstill to remember the victims of September 11.
10's US correspondent Daniel Sutton was at the main service at Ground Zero. He joins us now. Dan, this 10th anniversary was always going to be a very big occasion, therefore a difficult one for the families of those killed.
So, Bill, it was all about them, focusing on the individuals, those people's lives, and celebrating them rather than just focusing on that enormous number, almost 3,000, who died in the attacks here. It was an incredibly somber day, but it's also now a feeling of relief spreading across New York City that it went off without a hitch.
With a flower or a gentle caress, loved ones reached out to touch the names America holds dear.
Daddy, I love you and miss you, and I wish you could see me now.
The children of 9/11 reached out too.
You will always be my best friend and my hero. I love you with all of my heart, and I couldn't have ever asked for a greater daddy than you.
Some to parents they never even met.
I love you for loving the idea of having me. You gave me the gift of life, and I wish you could be here to enjoy it with me.
Six times a bell rang out across Ground Zero, at the exact times the four planes crashed, and the moment each of the towers fell.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
God bless every soul that we lost. God bless the family members who have to endure that loss.
And amid the tears in New York City, a lone Australian voice.
And the 10 Australians who were on foreign shores, we miss you all, and especially my twin brother, Andrew James Knox.
A decade after the evil which stole his brother, Stuart's heart still aches.
This year, I think, was harder. I think because of the fact that I needed to read Andrew's name this year.
From the Pentagon to a field in Pennsylvania and the Big Apple, it was a day when America stood together. There are so many names. Reading them all out takes almost 5 hours. It's a slow and sad process. But for the family members gathered here today, it's an acknowledgement that every life, every individual, is as important as the next. Politics was put aside as two presidents mourned together. Barack Obama spoke from the Bible.
We will not fear.
But did so from behind bulletproof glass. And as night fell, lights lit up the cascading pools. The new Freedom Tower glowed red, white and blue, and two streams of light shot powerfully into the sky. Beams for buildings which are gone, but people who won't be forgotten. In New York, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.
While the focus of 9/11 commemorations was on Ground Zero, tens of thousands more who couldn't get in paid their respects in a special way.
There were also signs of solidarity, with Australians being gifted a corner of New York to mourn.
It has become a painful but necessary ritual for the people of New York City. Mourners cram the streets, usually choked with traffic, getting as close as they possibly can to Ground Zero and its many victims.
I come here every single year. It's a sort of a healing process and just try to get rid of the pain.
Despite credible fears of a fresh terrorist attack, tens of thousands defiantly filled the streets. Every September since the Twin Towers fell, Tyrone McClave has sat quietly at the same intersection.
I believe that I'll see those people again someday, and I'll tell them, you know, they'll know that I was here in memory of them. Their lives were snuffed out. There's a lot of people that are just not going to forget that or forget them.
A decade ago, these young Australians were in high school. Today, they listened for 5 hours as the names of 2,977 victims echoed through the city.
It's really overwhelming. Like, you can actually feel the pain, like, when they're reading out the names. It's pretty devastating. It's really powerful.
My Year 12 teacher lost his twin brother in one of the towers, so sort of a little bit of a connection. I thought it was be good to come here to the site and be here for the 10th anniversary.
For we are young and free.
10 years on, relatives of Australian victims now finally have a place to grieve after a section of Britain's memorial gardens were gifted in their honour.
It's a place for all Australians can come to, and today it's particularly for the victims' families themselves.
Brooklyn's Red Hook firefighters were among the first on the scene, crew members once again standing shoulder to shoulder and bowing their heads in silence. Some chose to spend the day at church offering prayers of comfort, while others reflected at the newly opened Empty Sky Memorial, overlooking the city which the World Trade Center once dominated. From a field of 3,000 flags to the very top of New York's famous Times Square, those who lost their lives were remembered.
My dad was actually in the World Trade Center. He got out, but he was on the 30th floor of the North Tower, so 9/11 definitely holds a personal place in my heart.
But some hearts here were filled with anger. Tempers flared as conspiracy groups held a protest and faced off with mourners as they left the memorial. 9/11 will always be a date etched in world history, but as the years pass, those affected by the tragedy have a growing desire to mourn for their loved ones in private, away from the public glare. And that means living life as normal, New York and its heroes turning out in force to cheer for their team.
If those people could be here today, you know, they would be saying, you know, don't be afraid, you know, go on and live your life as you see it, be happy.
In New York, Brett Mason, 10 News.